Two Forks Tower. Two Forks Tower, this is Thoroughfare Tower. Come in. I know you're there. Your lights are on.
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
Okay, you're probably out here because nobody back home can stand you. Which, after this brief introduction, is not a big shock.
Ouch! I'll chalk that up to you being tired and grumpy.
Well, I'd better get some sleep then.
One sec. Now it's my turn.
Okay. Good night. Bye.
Let's see. I don't know anything about you, but 9 times out of 10, folks out here simply got dumped.
Huh. Is that it?
Close?
Good night.
Good night. Welcome to the job. Good morning, Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
Hey, sorry, guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, what, 14 hours of sleep? Woo!
Yeah, Jesus, I guess it's, what, 6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing? Are those fucking fireworks?
Whoa, that's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set him straight.
Like, kick the shit out of him sort of straight?
No. Jesus, no.
What? I'm not a cop. It's not like I've got a rule book over here.
Just make sure they don't do it again. Take their shit.
All right, fine.
Don't feed anyone a knuckle sandwich. Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Convenient.
That's one word for it.
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans. They threw them all over hell.
Are you fucking serious?
Yeah. Sure am.
I would like to retract my statement about knuckle sandwiches. Feet away.
What do you know? People with shitty manners drink shitty beer.
What, you don't like a cold Musquelite on a hot day?
No, I do. But then again, I didn't say my manners were any good. Better than these fucking litter bugs, though, that's for sure. They left their packs tied up here.
Don't fuck with them. The last thing we need is some hikers filing a report about harassment.
Well, I put out their fire.
Man, I would have named that forest fire something good, too.
Hey, I can always restart it.
No. I think your first instinct was the right one.
I left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
Well, confiscate them.
Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people. What if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
I found a bra.
A nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
There are, panties.
There are what?
I don't want to say that word again.
Why, because you're 12?
There's, ooh.
Yes?
There are two naked ladies out here.
Can you handle that?
Come on, I like naked ladies, same as anyone, but there's, you know.
Two?
Yeah.
I know this will be tough for you, but try to pick your tongue up off the ground and do your job.
Okay. I found them in the lake.
Skinny dipping?
Yeah.
Is that a guy over there?
Oh boy, enjoy dealing with that.
I know you guys are setting up bottle rockets out here, okay?
How? Because you're hiding in the bushes, spying on us?
Give him a break, Lily. He probably hasn't seen boobs in 20 years.
He's probably still a virgin. I hate this.
Let's get out of here.
Duck all of your stuff. The fireworks, the whiskey, you name it.
What? You dick!
Also, setting off fireworks out here isn't just stupid, it's illegal.
Yeah, so is stealing, asshole.
So fucking bogus.
You're gonna pay for that.
Can we just get out of here?
Ew, totally.
You're gross.
You're just some sad man out in the woods.
Hey, that go okay?
It's done.
Well, that's ominous.
Hopefully there won't be any more trouble.
Good. Thanks for going down there.
Hey, there's a trail to Two Forks Tower down here near the lake.
Yeah, that's your tower.
So I should go this way.
Well, you're not climbing back up that slide. So, I have a bit of a confession to make.
What is it?
Look, I was drunk last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of a thing to a minimum. Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
Oh, I can see my tower from far away.
Yeah, we experimented with hidden underground towers for a while, but we weren't really happy with the results.
You did not.
No. No, we didn't. Anyway, happy hiking.
Hey, I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad, right? Because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home, and try not to get hit by lightning.
I got hit by lightning when I was 9 years old, so I'm safe. It's not gonna strike twice and all that.
Well, there was an old lookout named Roy Sullivan who got hit by lightning 7 times.
I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, well, if it makes you feel any better, it wasn't what killed him.
What killed him?
Suicide. Would you believe?
There's some guy out here.
Some guy? Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Henry, there's something something someone should have told you about this area.
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. And people come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
Look, bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun. What can I do for you?
Well, my typewriter is on the ground, outside of my tower.
You write?
Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell...
You should get inside.
Fuck me. Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
My fucking sheets are gone.
They stole your sheets? That's just mean.
Yeah, it sucks. The place is trashed.
Okay, I put in a call.
What can they do about it? Will they catch whoever did it?
This is the Forest Service, Henry. They're not exactly Hawaii 5-0. Do you have any idea who would have done this?
Maybe that guy I saw in the canyon, but I don't know why the fuck he'd want to mess with my stuff.
Well, I'll have the Rangers keep an eye out for a man hiking on his own and question him if they find him. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some deranged hiker going after lookouts? Great. Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Well, I sure don't now.
You will. I promise. Wake up!
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either. I don't really know why that would be the case.
There's no backup?
The backup is the 2-day hike out of here.
So, that's a no?
It's easier for me to send all the lookouts out to check the status of the wire in their areas. Yours is a good hike away. If you find any portion of it down, I can try to get a hold of a ranger and he'll bring someone in to fix it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So, you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, all right.
Oh, it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
I just spend a lot of time with Julia.
Oh, so you have someone there?
Well...
But you're taking a little break, or...
We're...
Look, I'm sorry. Can you hold that thought?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea. I'm absolutely sure. Would you? All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard. Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Julia, girlfriend? Ex? Sorry, I don't mean to pry.
Who was that?
Who was who?
I don't think he has any idea. What was that? Were you talking about me?
What?
You left your button pressed or something.
Henry, that call was work. I was just talking to... Actually, it's not really your business. Why are you freaking out?
I'm not freaking out.
Good. I'm gonna go quiet for a little bit. Call me if it's important.
Yeah, okay, the wire's down here.
Okay, good. Any sign of those girls? Did they mess with anything?
I'll look around. Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far. Hey, sorry about snapping at you earlier. I thought about it, and yeah, I suppose that must have sounded kind of weird when you heard me take that other call. Plus, you're just out here in your own head. Trust me, I know how it is. So, did you break any hearts back in Colorado when you took this job? I myself have chosen to never get attached to anyone who would miss me, but I know I'm a bit of an outlier. I don't mean that the way it sounds. I mean, I care about people, and I like companionship as much as the next person. But why does it have to come from the same person for your whole life? My Aunt Kathy was married to the same guy for 4 decades, and when he died, she found out he'd been having an affair with a real estate broker. For 15 years. Whereas my Aunt Judy traveled the world dating artists and musicians as she saw fit. Call me crazy, but I'd rather spend a week in bed with Sonny Bono than half a lifetime with some cheating stockbroker.
I'm actually married.
But you're here.
She's sick, and I shouldn't be here, but I am.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
Look, I gotta go do a thing, but I'll have a radio. Okay, call me if you need to.
Hey, Delilah?
What do you got? You found him?
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain-link fence?
A chain-link fence?
Yeah, it looks like it surrounds a huge area.
Huh, that's weird.
Who are they keeping out of here? And why?
Geez, I don't know. Maybe it's biologists, you know? Well, they don't want people traipsing on their precious lichens.
What's a lichen?
Well, wouldn't you lichen to know?
Oh my god, goodbye.
I'll ask next time I talk to someone, but that'll probably be a few days. What does she have?
She's got Alzheimer's. Dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
We were scared shitless. We went straight to the doctor after her first spell or whatever. They diagnosed her and we were both just very scared. Can't really tell when Julia is scared. She just gets quiet. She was very quiet. I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards 5 Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
So, how'd you meet?
Met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I stumbled over and told her she was pretty, and that was it.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk. I'm down in Thunder Canyon. I'm not seeing that smoke anymore.
Oh, it's still burning away. Try heading west from where you are. If you loop past the lake, there should be a trail that'll take you further south.
Thanks. That helps.
What are you going to do when the fire season wraps up? Are you going to go be with her? Just go back to Boulder? You should go be with her.
Maybe I'll go visit. I don't know.
Well, why not?
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents, I think they always thought she could do better, and that I could have done a better job looking after her.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
If you want to go visit her, you should go. Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it. There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around. I see a campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
It seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is. Ah, found my sheets!
So they did break into your tower.
Looks like... These girls have a full case of beer left here. A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication. I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's another one of those magazines. I don't get why the hunks have to be so dangerous.
Well, you're clearly not a young woman.
Girls should want nice hunks.
Ugh, boring.
Pants are back.
I'm sorry, pants are back?
Well, according to the experts at Teen Zone magazine. It's unclear where they've been. The pants, I mean. Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder, which would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it, did not hold back.
You've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking. Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
They're threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No, well, hey, I didn't do this, okay? Someone or something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
Yeah, I took their whiskey back at the lake, but that just felt like, I don't know, the cost of doing business.
That's different, okay? And I don't blame you.
This is, I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Hey, Henry?
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial. This isn't that hard.
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Oh, that's too bad. I read in People he's like 5 foot nothing.
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Clothes. I don't really think about it.
Oh, come on.
I got a sweatshirt I like, a good jacket I got at the Buckle Barn.
Ooh, I love the Buckle Barn.
Just one of those brown ones, you know?
I do. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
Pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Your what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
They're steely. A cold, hard stare.
Like a Siberian husky.
Sure.
Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and, I'll give it to you.
Okay, now I'm ready. Let's get to work.
How were those precious few seconds of jobless freedom?
Oh, magical.
Good. Now get to work. Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
Not too bad. I could get used to it out here.
That's nice. Look, I called with bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
It's a coincidence. How many pairs of girls go backpacking?
Probably a lot.
Yeah, probably a lot.
So I guess you didn't get their names then? Look, it's not gonna be an issue. If they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset. Henry? Henry, wake up. Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
I don't know. There's some weird stuff going on.
Oh, that's too bad.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function. So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night. You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I shouldn't be out here.
Yes, you should.
No, I just ran away from my problems.
No, you didn't. We all fuck up. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Waltz was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine. He'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that. It'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here. I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. So, I lied to you. I came out here with a broken heart just like you. I figured you've told me so much about you. So, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
Delilah's a nice name.
No, you big dummy.
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
I like it. So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
I've had one too many bad experiences with tequila. I'm a little reticent to try it again.
Well, maybe you just need a new, good experience with it.
Yeah, maybe.
Are you looking at the fire?
Yeah, I am.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Sure you are.
I am.
I don't know what that means.
It doesn't matter. I get it. With Julie and everything, you probably don't want to be here.
I don't know if that's true.
Forget I said anything. I I just meant I like that you're here. Why don't we both just go watch this fire and try to imagine all the old dead things it's burning away? You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Huh. Problem bear? Fuck that. I am of the opinion that they are all problems.
Come on, please.
Ugh. Can't believe I'm gonna leave this planet as a pile of bear shit.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah. Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the Fish and Game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
What the... it's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry? I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating. Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo? Oh, God. I don't know why I just called you that. Henry? Are you there? What happened, Henry?
Holy hell, I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you. This just seems like a misunderstanding or something.
Look, I know what I saw. Hey, it was our words with initials for our names, H and D, clear as day.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Okay, I'm sorry, I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with the walkie-talkie taking notes and talking to God knows who. What do you think is going on behind that fence?
Apparently a lot of following you around taking notes, which is unfucking believable, Henry.
Yeah, you're telling me. All right, I'm on my way to Wapiti Meadow. I'll let you know what I find.
Okay. There's got to be a reasonable explanation. Also, I'm gonna call around and see if anyone's had anything weird happen to them or seemed spooked. I don't want to make this bigger than it is yet, you know?
Yeah, understood.
Yeah, okay. Hike safe.
Okay, I'm at the fence. I don't see anyone around, but I'm not sure I can get past it.
How big is it?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
That's not what this is.
We'll see what you can do to get past it.
Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Look, I'm not gonna be able to get into this place.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
If you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence. Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Should we call the cops or the Forest Service and let them know this is going on?
Don't you think that would sound, you know, crazy?
Yeah, it is crazy. We have to tell someone.
Tell them what, Henry? Tell them we're being stalked and you were attacked and we don't have any proof?
I don't know. Tell them we're being bothered or something.
Henry, I really like this job, okay? And if I give off even a hint of cuckoo to my bosses, they are never gonna let me come back out here. Do you understand that?
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay, keep your radio close to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I'm not, okay? Let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
He had his dad to protect him. Ned, right?
Yeah.
You don't think he could?
No, you're probably right.
It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
You ever talked to any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
I mean, he wasn't a scout or a weeblow or whatever?
I got the sense that boy could barely tie his shoes, let alone a clove hitch.
What the hell's a clove hitch?
Well, it's a knot that you are probably too old and too stubborn to learn. You use it to make rafts and shelters and stuff like that.
Huh. You know how to tie one?
Heck no. I'd make a weeblow do it.
I guess these little shelters are where they keep the weeblows.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
There are bear traps out here, in the scout shelters.
Scouts are stalwart prey.
That's messed up. Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Damn.
Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would meet someone who'd give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
I do, yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
I'm gonna do a scan for supplies and then figure out a way to get back over that ravine and hike towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge help.
For both getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Yeah, I'm out of here.
Are you there? I had a thought.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, fuck.
There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios.
What about when I heard you talking to someone else?
I just left your line open. That's not what this is. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today. The June fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
Are you kidding right now? Did you not stay up all night knowing that someone is...
I actually slept just great.
Okay.
By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
All right.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
Great. Just wonderful. Do you see the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Let me look at it and I'll tell you.
No. You don't need to tell me. Just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
Which tree am I supposed to internalize again?
Top row, second from the left. Head to a place named after that tree, and you'll have a wonderful afternoon.
I'm here at Cottonwood Creek.
You see the cash box there?
It must be around here somewhere.
It is. Find it and open it. I changed the code. It's 5678.
Are you kidding me?
I was in a rush.
I've got it now.
Good. I spent all day getting you that radio. I hiked to a cash box, lied to a ranger, lied to another ranger, and hopefully you are now holding a clean, untapped radio.
Hopefully.
Holy fuck, Henry, we have to get into that site. Whatever these people are doing is illegal, right? We need to find out how they're doing it, why, everything.
What the fuck is going on? People are listening to us?
I don't know.
Our radios are tapped? Are you fucking serious?
Our radios are definitely tapped. That's why I left you the one you just got.
How is this even possible?
I don't know, Henry.
What do you know?
You know that I'm scared. None of it makes any sense.
Are there any other lookouts this is happening to? Someone else in on this? Anyone?
This is just happening to us. Everyone else is fine.
Are you sure?
Yes. I've tried to bring it up to Chimney Rock, Elk's Fork, and Beartooth Lookout, and every one of them got confused. Asked me if I'm okay and if I need to be relieved. Our fucking state coordinator asked if I was just having lady troubles. So no, this isn't happening to anyone else, and I'm done asking.
Who is doing this?
I don't know who could be doing this. Henry, I've been at this job off and on for 13 years. Sometimes here, sometimes over near Jackson, a couple times down in Wind River. And nothing like this has ever happened before.
Am I just making all of this up? I mean, the eavesdropping, the spying, is this... Fuck, are you... Is any of this real?
What? Are you serious?
Maybe I'm just losing my mind.
What?
Like Julia. And maybe it's happening to me, and I'm imagining that I have a boss out here and that we're being spied on.
Henry.
Maybe there was something in the water, or our condo was underneath some power lines, and you, Delilah, you're not real.
Henry, think about her. If what happened to her were happening to you, you wouldn't even be able to realize it.
Okay.
Henry, sweetie, I am real and this is happening. I'm as real as the sky is blue. Take a second and then call me back. I'm on your side.
Okay, I'm all right. I'm headed towards the site.
Good. Keep your head up. Hey, I just thought of something not great.
What is it?
I filed a report that said that neither of us ever talked to or saw those girls, the ones that went missing a few weeks back.
What? Why would you do that? I told you to say the minimum and just keep it vague.
I know. And I didn't. I just didn't want to be hassled.
And now someone probably has a transcript of that entire conversation.
And I've filed a report that's a blatant lie.
Oh, and those girls are still missing.
Yep.
Fuck, Delilah.
Fuck indeed. We really need to get to the bottom of this.
I'm busting the gate down. There's nobody around, and it's the quickest way in.
Copy that.
I smashed open the gate. Should I try to fix or hide this?
No, screw it.
Okay, then. Okay, I'm at the site. I don't see anybody around.
Lucky for us.
Yeah, lucky for us. Dee, there is some serious comms equipment out here, wireless stuff.
What do you mean?
I'm talking a big 20-foot-tall transmission tower. And they could probably listen to whoever the hell they want. They're nestled down in this valley, which makes it impossible for you or any lookout to see them. Now, they're doing something with the soil out here, too. It's all gritted off. Hey, maybe you were right about the lichens. And there are all sorts of contraptions and shit out here.
Like what?
Dishes and stuff on metal legs. There are wires all over the place. I don't know. I'm not really up on high tech. This equipment is not stuff from the hardware store. I'm in their main tent.
What's it like?
It's definitely some sort of monitoring station. I just wonder where they are. All of their stuff is here.
And they know you're there, so see what you can find and get out.
I found their main monitoring desk.
Oh my god, what do you see? Seriously, at this stage, I'd believe just about anything.
That desk in here is a mess. I mean, it's like someone was in a rush or knocked a bunch of stuff over on accident. Okay. Shit. Got a map here that confirms they're tracking our people's movements. The map's got all sorts of paths and areas marked off on it. There are lines that look like some of the paths I normally take.
Are you positive it's you?
I'm not sure, but I think so. Okay, so there's a log here that tracks the movement of four distinct subjects.
You and me?
Yeah, definitely me. And I suppose you too.
What about the other two?
Maybe the Goodwins? What if they were following them last summer?
God, Henry, I don't know. If they were, there's no way Brian knew. He would have said something.
Yeah, I can't imagine a kid like that could have kept this under his hat.
We'll talk this over and figure out how to get the hell out of here.
They're measuring the barometric pressure, too. Why?
Maybe it's just a diversion.
There's some sort of monitor. I don't know what it does. Maybe air quality or something?
Maybe they're keeping data on everything that could impact our moods.
That looks possible. This is crazy. I mean, this stuff looks like it just got lifted out of the space shuttle.
I have to tell you, if I found out this was NASA, I'd be a hell of a lot happier.
There's a box here with a dial. It has a needle, like it measures earthquakes.
You mean like a lie detector?
Yeah, I'm not sticking around to get hooked up to it. This place sleeps three. They've got a row of cots here.
So they live and work in the same tent?
Yeah, it's all one operation.
Like us.
Yeah, like us. I think I found the thing they use to track us.
Holy shit!
You know, you swear, like, a lot.
Not the time, Hank.
Anyway, it's called a wave receiver. Looks like it picks up anything that emits a signal. It's got basic orienteering capabilities, everything.
Holy shit, Henry.
Yeah, holy shit.
You're gonna take it, right?
Yeah, of course. Okay, this thing is losing its mind, beeping like crazy.
I can hear it. What's it after?
I don't know. I'm gonna go find out. Folder of reports here.
What do they say?
They're assessments about the two of us. There's stuff in here about Julia.
Like what?
Stuff I didn't tell you. This is...
What does it say about me? You said there was one about me.
And it looks like they've been following me around. What I do when I'm out hiking? Jesus!
Henry, do you hear me?
It says that you and your boyfriend are still together.
What? We're not. They're messing with us.
Yeah, okay.
They are. How do they even know who he is? How the hell does this... I'm so sick of letting these people do this to us. We should just burn the place down. Think about it. Worst case scenario...
Delilah.
What? Think about it.
I am, and I think it's insane.
They'd be fucked.
Yeah, and how about if that fire comes up the mountain, or someone were to die in it?
We call it in?
We call it in?
Yeah, maybe.
My God, Delilah, no. No way.
Well, maybe it's not the best idea.
Yeah, it's definitely not the best idea.
Oh, I'm so fucking wound up.
It's all right. I'm just gonna hike back. We have the wave receiver, and tomorrow we can figure out what to do.
Delilah, there's smoke coming from the site. I just climbed out of there, and the bridge collapsed.
What the hell happened to you? It's definitely not the best idea.
It wasn't me.
What do we do?
I don't know. I have no idea what to do.
We have a fire burning in the woods. The one thing I know how to respond to, and all of this shit has me wondering what the hell to do. And what about who started it? What about them?
The person who started it?
Yeah.
We're talking about people watching us out here who are now burning the forest and everything in it around us. I don't know what to do about that.
Except get the hell out.
Yes, get us the hell out of here.
I will.
This receiver just picked something up.
Like a signal? It's going beep, beep.
Yeah, what could it be?
I don't know. You gotta find out.
All right, I'm on my way now.
You know what I just picked up?
No.
A fifth of Major Bueno tequila from the creek.
Are you drunk?
No! I am getting drunk!
Hey, Dee, I don't want to harsh your vibe, but maybe, just maybe, that's a bad idea.
Henry, Henry, Henry.
What?
You're harshing my vibe. My thinking is I could stay up all night worried I'm going to lose my job because of the side fire, or I could not worry and let the chips fall where they may. It's not like there's any proof we were down there.
My thinking is I'm going to follow this wave receiver.
I like it when you think.
Ay, ay, ay. I'll just leave you alone with whatever these thoughts are.
Shit! What?
Dee, I found some sort of supply bag, light camping gear, some clothes, you know, basics, but it was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
Yeah, I'm fine, but there's also a set of keys here. I don't know why they'd be hidden out here. They say Shoshone National Forest, Cave 452. Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah, it is. Who the hell took them?
And what the hell is in that cave?
Okay, let's just think.
Says the woman with a half a bottle of tequila in her belly.
Maybe they're panicking and we're preparing to beat it. The fire has them spooked and we have new walkie-talkies, so we have the upper hand.
Yeah, well, it's hard to feel like you have the upper hand when you're standing in the dark in the middle of the woods.
Oh. Well, you're back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
I'm not in my tower.
I am looking at a man standing in your lookout. And it's not you.
Is not me.
Oh my god, go.
I'm going. Hey, I got turned around. Is that person still there?
No, he's gone.
I'll call you when I get back. I don't see anyone up here.
He was just there.
Left a cassette player taped to my damn door.
I don't even know what to say to that.
Well, let's see what's on it. Talking down at the site. It sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
Dee, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh my god, what the fuck is happening?
What's wrong?
Someone claiming to be Henry in Two Forks called a lookout in another sector early this morning and said that I knew what caused the Wapiti Meadow fire. So, I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it. Furthermore, I bet you don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
Us? What's this us? You're the boss. I was just...
What, following orders?
Look, you know I didn't start this fire. So you just tell him the truth, right? That's all you can do?
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
I know.
Hey, you... You didn't actually make that call, right? To the other lookout? It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kind of just wish I hadn't.
Of course I didn't. No way. They're trying to pit us against each other.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
That's not gonna happen, though.
Thanks, Henry.
Jesus, this is a big cave.
Is anybody down there?
Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus!
So you didn't find anything?
No. There's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes. I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous.
Delilah, I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Really?
Yeah, he built himself a real castle. Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
What, you're saying I'm one of those knuckleheads, is that it?
I wasn't, but, now that I think about it...
Because I know lots of stuff.
Oh, please, drown me in your surplus of knowledge. I've been waiting all these years for a man as wise as you to take this job.
Well, that wait's over, sweetheart.
Call me sweetheart again, and you'll use that big sexy brain of yours to fill out your unemployment paperwork.
Sorry, boss. I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler. He made the place pretty comfy, too.
That's an achievement.
Yeah, at the expense of what are probably stolen pillows.
That little shit.
It's a little weird that he'd just leave so much of his stuff out here.
Well, maybe they were in a hurry when they left. Like I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied, and just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
He also stole his dad's climbing equipment, his anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was gonna hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. I mean, he left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah, it sounds like Ned was pushing him, and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put it past old Ned.
He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left. There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Yeah, I think that was the one thing Ned did do with him, you know, tinkering on stuff like that.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
There's some grade-A dork contraband here.
You found his pocket protector?
I found a data sheet for one Gladius Silva, half-elf, armor 7.
Classic wizards and wyverns.
Yeah, between this and the map I found in my tower, old Brian created quite the fantasy world.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved out there.
He'd hide out here to read comics. The black band, his grief is his enemy's sorrow. Everyone this guy loves gets killed, so he honors them with a black armband which gives him superpowers.
Well, that's fucking dark.
Bunch of rocks stacked up. He made a wall and a perimeter.
God. Yeah, that's perfect.
You know, maybe he made it because he was afraid of them.
Whenever I think of Brian possibly going through this crap, I get sick to my stomach.
Yeah. Sorry.
What do you think is in there?
I don't know, really. I mean, we gotta find out. What do you think?
Whatever it is, they don't want you telling anyone about.
I mean, they closed the door when they could have just
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
Are you serious with this shit right now?
A hatchet. God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
Honestly, I just want to know. I want to know what is worth doing everything that's been done to us.
Yeah, me too. And not going to jail would be a nice kicker. Oh, also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them. Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and, landed in jail.
I wonder if they know anything. If there's some way to ask them about whatever happened at their camp.
I think we'd be smart to let sleeping dogs lie.
You're probably right. Oh, God. You're Brian Goodwin. You fell. Your stuff gave out. Hey, Dee.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
You need to call search and rescue.
What?
There's a body in the cave. It's Brian Goodwin.
You gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or... made to look like a climbing accident?
Mm-hmm.
I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. But whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him. What do we do now, Dee? I mean, are you okay?
No. I'm not. He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway. You see that plane?
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Well, is this the June fire or the site fire?
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
About how all this stuff is connected. The surveillance, the Goodwins, Brian's death.
Look, I don't know what to say, okay? It's like the universe cooked up the cruelest thing to have happen. Does it connect to everything else? I don't know. I don't know if I even want to.
Of course you do. There's gotta be a reason.
Does there?
Maybe. Maybe not. I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Well, fuck. For starters, I guess you could find the source of that signal.
Holy crap. Yeah, oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us, whoever made the tape.
Okay, yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
All right, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
I was hoping you'd have a backup plan or something.
Yeah, okay, I'm probably gonna move to Canada. Ontario, maybe.
No, I meant if something happens to me.
Right, if you don't find out who made the tape and I have to hit the road.
Forget it.
Be safe, Henry. What's your status?
I think I'm getting close.
All right, well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
Someone left a rope for me to climb up. I'm down near the lake.
How do you know it's for you?
There's a tracking collar tied to it. Someone was leading me here. and there's another tape.
Oh my God, Henry.
Yeah, hi, Henry. Hey, you better find this before it burns up. We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Now I gotta go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for croc's sake. I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and I ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids, all right? Nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know, I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
Ned Goodwin? He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. He's deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son. You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay. Goodwin was the one who wrote the reports I found at the site. He wrote down everything he did to us. And everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
I bet.
He held on to some of Brian's things. His wizards and wyverns.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he found it riveting.
God.
What?
Nothing, just some of Brian's stuff. Brian was a nice-looking kid.
Yeah.
You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I don't know what you want me to say. We're in the middle of a fire that is at 22,000 acres and growing. Fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well, take a picture if you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
I don't know.
He's got a radio base station up here. He was listening to us on that. He had quite the view.
I know I should be relieved. Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. He was a sweet kid.
with a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
Delilah, I think it was an accident. And I don't think Ned meant to kill him.
We don't know what happened for sure.
Ned wanted his son to be able to climb and do the sorts of things he did himself, but Brian couldn't.
And how'd that turn out, Henry? I'm sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, I did. And now I've got to decide whether I tell people that he's down there so they can retrieve the body or not. And if I do, I'm going to be asked about Ned Goodwin.
Dee?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Dee, what if they don't come back for me?
They'll come back. That's their job.
Just what if we missed something about, something, I don't know.
Henry, you're tired. There's nothing big going on. They'll come back for you.
Just wait.
I'm gonna go.
Okay. If you have to.
I have to. Hike safe.
Hey, I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there? Delilah? Hello? Is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me. I'm back at the staging area near the trailhead. I think I see your truck.
Red? Colorado plates?
Yeah. It's a piece of shit.
Hey, that's a man's pickup you're talking about.
I think there might be a raccoon living in it.
Make sure he's comfy, I guess.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me and I'll choose for you?
All right, sure. Maybe... Maybe you could come back to Boulder with me and figure it out down there. Just a thought.
You don't want me down there.
Well, I just asked you.
Look, I've got some things to do in Casper, and maybe I'll head south sometime after that. I could come by, sure.
Okay. So, what about me?
I think you should go to Julia. And then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Yeah, sure.
Henry, Look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
You're right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could,
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year, we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
Yeah?
Well, you should try to take her advice, too.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
You too. Good luck.
No. Henry, you keep it for yourself, okay? Bye, Hank.
See you walk away from me.